Hello and welcome back. Let's dive into quantum Monte Carlo. We'll start by briefly discussing the classical Monte Carlo method and its application in industry. Then we'll examine quantum Monte Carlo and how it enhances the capabilities of classical Monte Carlo techniques. And finally, we'll implement quantum Monte Carlo in MATLAB using the MATLAB support package for quantum computing to compute the mean of a function of a random variable. Monte Carlo methods are algorithms that rely on repeated random number sampling to approximate a desired quantity. Monte Carlo simulations are extensively utilized in fields like engineering, physics, and finance to model and analyze complex systems. As a result, these techniques are popular across various industries due to their powerful capabilities. For examples and more information on Monte Carlo methods, check out the links below. Quantum Monte Carlo, a suite of algorithms within quantum computing, extend the capabilities of classical Monte Carlo methods by incorporating quantum mechanical effects like superposition and entanglement. For an overview on quantum computing, visit the Introduction to Quantum Computing page linked below. Research shows that quantum Monte Carlo offers a quadratic speedup compared to classic Monte Carlo methods. Quantum Monte Carlo methods are powerful computational techniques that have potential to speed up simulations when compared to classical Monte Carlo. Let's take a look at a short demo of a basic example to compute the mean of a function of a random variable using the MATLAB support package for quantum computing and the Statistics and Machine Learning Toolbox. This demo will help you extend quantum Monte Carlo to other problems. In this demo, we want to calculate the mean of the trigonometric function sine squared x, given that x follows a normal distribution. Analytically, it's straightforward, as we can compute the mean directly, in this case using mean mu is equal to sine hyperbolic 1 divided by e. The value is 0.4323. We now know what we are expecting as a solution from classic Monte Carlo and the quantum Monte Carlo. Let's use classic Monte Carlo to perform the same problem. For better understanding, we break it down into three steps. The first step is generating the normal distribution for x. The second, calculating the value of the analytical value of sine squared x for every generated x. And finally, the mean value of the function using the evaluated values of the function. Here's a visualization of the generated distribution for x on the left and function value along the mean on the right. The mean of the function value is close to the analytical mean. Next, let's dive into the quantum Monte Carlo approach. On the right, you can see the circuit for a quantum Monte Carlo algorithm. As a first step, we generate a discretized normal distribution for the variable x and encode this distribution onto 5 probability qubits. Due to the power of entanglement, these 5 qubits are capable of representing 32 distinct quantum states. Here is the generated discretized normal distribution of the variable x in the range negative pi to pi, with 2 to the power of 5 being 32 discrete intervals, as 5 probability qubits can encode 32 amplitudes. We then calculate sine squared x at each of the 32 x intervals and normalize it to calculate the expected discrete mean of the function, which is 0.4326. Now we move on to the part of the circuit which loads the probability distribution. We initialize the 5 probability qubits and encode 32 amplitudes directly using the init gate function in our support package. We can also verify if the qubits loaded the distribution correctly by visualizing the qubit output after initialization. In the second step, we encode the mean of the function sine squared x calculated on the discrete x value of the value qubit. To compute the mean of this function, you need to sample this value qubit and find its probability of being in state 1. In this step, to estimate the mean within a specific error bound, you need several samples that are still comparable to the classical Monte Carlo. Speedup can be obtained by applying the algorithm for amplitude estimation and using additional qubits to store the result. Here we encode the function value of 0.4326 on the value qubit, which is the sixth qubit in our circuit. We append all the gate operations from the previous encoding step and current encoding of the value qubit to call it the F circuit. To cross-verify the operation, we compute the probability of the value qubit being in state 1, which outputs the variable value of discrete mean as expected. Here is the third and last step of the quantum phase estimation algorithm, for which we define another 6 estimation qubits that are used to measure the phase information that is encoded in the value qubit. We can increase the number of qubits to increase the numeric precision of the estimated phase, as a greater number of qubits will be able to create more precision to the binary value. Here is the code block for extracting the phase information from the value qubit using a quantum amplitude estimation algorithm. This algorithm uses a series of controlled unitary operations, keeping the value qubit as the controlled qubit. These 6 qubits will output the phase information from the circuit in binary at the end of computation. Let's do a quick recap of the circuit blocks implemented. The F block loads the probability distribution into m probability qubits and encodes the function mean value to the value qubit. The Q blocks and the inverse quantum Fourier transform, QFT, creates the quantum phase estimation. The algorithm achieves a speedup by needing only a quadratically smaller number of samples compared to the classical Monte Carlo method to compute the mean within a specific error bound. Finally, we use the MATLAB state vector simulator within the support package to simulate and plot the circuit. The output is the estimated phase, theta, related to the analytical mean of the function, using the equation mu equals 1 minus cosine pi theta over 2. Using the analytic solution from the beginning, we can calculate this analytic phase and plot it along the phases calculated by quantum Monte Carlo. From the estimated phase, we can find the mean value of the function based on quantum Monte Carlo. The mean values obtained using different methods are displayed in the table by comparing the analytical value, classical Monte Carlo value, discretized value, and quantum Monte Carlo value. Some key takeaways from this demo are that the quantum Monte Carlo results are comparable to all other techniques. Quantum Monte Carlo can store the variable distribution at once generated by a random number generator in parallel, thus utilizing fewer resources. Also, we used phased estimation, speeding up the simulation when compared to classical Monte Carlo. I hope you found this example useful and can apply the demonstrated workflow to your own problems and studies. You can find the example used in this video linked in the description. To learn more about the MATLAB support package for quantum computing, please check out our Quantum Computing with MATLAB webpage. Leave your thoughts in the comments section down below on which quantum algorithm implementation you'd like us to cover next. Thanks for watching and happy coding!